In this segment of the Slate tutorial, I'll demonstrate how to release decisions for an application. There are a couple ways to release decisions. One is to do them in bulk, and the other one is to do them one at a time. And here at Cairn, probably the best would be to do them one at a time because of the volume. And it's going to be easier as well, less complex. So notice here at this stage, this is awaiting a decision for this application. That's the status of it. So we need to go down here under decisions to add the new decision for the release of this decision. Now, before you make a decision, obviously you want to take a look at the review forms. Review forms, this would be the forms that the counselors have completed, or it could be the forms that the director of admissions, a scholarship review submitted, or the deans have submitted as well. You can click on the forms, you can see the comments that they submitted, and so on. So in this case, they are recommending that it would be a conditional academic. So we go here to a new decision, and then we need to select a decision code. In most cases, you're going to select the admit decision. Then the next component here is that you need to provide a reason for the admission. So you're going to select admit conditional academic. And then as for the letter, this is where you would specify what letter to choose. By default, it's going to send this one. Then it's important to also select these next two options because they are required. So confirmed, that means that you're confirming this decision at this date and time. Remember, this is a major thing, action that you're taking. Then under released, this is where you're going to specify when the student can view it, when it can be released for the student to view it. You can schedule them, obviously, in the future. And it is recommended that you actually select here about 15 minutes from the time that you're going to publish or confirm them. Then you can put here comments. And if you have custom letters that you want to send them or custom documents, you can attach them from here. Now, once you press save, a whole bunch of stuff happens behind the scenes. And typically, the system will update those changes within 15 minutes or so. To run the updates immediately, you need to force an update on this profile. Now, if the student goes to their portal at this point in time, they are going to see that there is a new update on their application. They will also receive an email within 24 hours. The email is kind of delayed because they prefer, or Slate prefers, that you send them a paper copy first, and then they get the digital version of the admission thing. So in my case, I'm going to force an update on this record at this time. And then I'm going to simulate, go and log in as a student and see what it looks like for the process. So the record has been updated at this point. Now I'm going to log in, or I'm actually logged in as the Cairn Online account. I'll reload it, refresh it. Notice it says there's a status update. The student will go here to view update, and they'll get this letter. Obviously, that'll be the actual name of the student, and it gives them the next steps for what they need to do. They can click here because they need to let us know. Sometimes they apply to more than one college, and we need to know whether they are still planning to come to Cairn or not. Now, in this case, they can click here to reply to the offer of admission, or they can go to the portal, and there will be a link in there as well. So they come in here, and they can choose to decline, and then we kind of prefer that they give us a reason why, or they go here to accept, and then they press submit. At this point, notice that they are prompted to then next submit the payment of $150. They can click in here and pay via credit card or using a bank account. So that's what the process will look on the student side of things. Now, if we return back to the record needs to be updated. So if we refresh it, notice that there are pending updates because the student responded with some kind of action. Now, in this next part, I'm going to show you how you can waive the fee the deposit fee for particular students, because there will be cases where you need to waive that fee at the graduate level or whatever level there, obviously with permission and so on. So you come down here under activities and notice that there is a payment due for this particular applicant. You'll click on it and notice there's an option for payment waived. You will click on payment waived, and then you're simply, you can put comments down here, grad student or whatever, and then press save. Next, you'll need to wait either 15 minutes for the systems to update, or you can run an update on this record manually. And then if we press display, at this point, you'll notice that the application status, it will show as decided. If we go to the record, it says decided, and it is, the student is in enroll status, and it's a confirmed enroll status. So pretty much you're done with the student as far as getting them through the application process.